Hey guys, I'm here with a quick review of a Bath & Body Works candle. This is my first candle review I've done in quite a while, probably about a couple of months now. I honestly just haven't done reviews much because I haven't been buying that many candles. We're really tight on money right now, so I basically honestly just haven't been able to buy candles. I can't afford it right now, so I'm trying to buckle down and not buy any new candles. Trust me, it's been hard because they've had a lot of new collections that have been coming out, and they've had sales quite a bit lately, actually. And I passed up quite a few of the sales because I just knew I was trying to watch our money, so I didn't want to buy any of them. I did want to buy them, but I made myself not buy them, I should say. So I was good and haven't bought any of them, but I did get three from my mom for my birthday. So I have burned two of them so far, and I'm going to review those. And I have one more I'll probably review when I burn that one, because she got me three different ones. So this is the first one that I'm going to review. This is from the new, I believe it's being called House of Blues collection. And this is in the scent Honey Vanilla. And I will read you the description. It says rich vanilla, warm tonka bean, and wildflower honey. When I first smelled this at the store, I pretty much got kind of like a mixture of vanilla bean Noel and vanilla bean, and which is like a slight kind of a honey note to it. Not a real strong honey, but just a little bit. And I was skeptical to get it because vanilla bean Noel usually is very light, almost unscented when you burn it. But I love that scent so much, and I'm always hoping maybe if I do buy it that I'll be able to smell it because it's such a good scent. So I thought maybe I'll try this one, and maybe if it does smell like that, that'll be fine with me because I like that scent a lot, but usually the candle doesn't throw very well. So I went ahead and bought this one because I do like vanilla scents. Like I said, they're just normally fairly light for the most part, even though some vanilla bean candles will be stronger, and then like vanilla bean marshmallows, some of those have been strong in the past, but not so much vanilla bean Noel. So I bought this one and then burned it. And once I started burning it, I was actually pleasantly surprised. It actually didn't come off as vanilla bean Noel when I burned it. I didn't really get that at all. I kind of got the vanilla bean candle somewhat, but not exactly either. Mostly what I get with this candle is it smells just like vanilla ice cream. A lot of people have mentioned that on Instagram and different places on Facebook and things and Facebook candle groups. And I totally agree. That's exactly what I get from it. It's just like you have a scoop of ice cream on an ice cream cone or in a bowl or whatever, and that's what it smells like. That nice vanilla ice cream. It could be vanilla bean. It's not super, super vanilla bean-like, but it does have a hint of that. It could almost be kind of a cross between French vanilla and vanilla bean a little bit. It's not super just vanilla bean, and it's not super just French vanilla. It's just basically just a nice creamy ice cream. And then just a little bit of, like, if you would just put a little bit of honey on there. Not super, super honey-like. For instance, Honey and Tangerine. Now, that had a lot more honey note to it. This is nowhere near that as far as the honey scent goes. It's just a tad bit of honey in there. Just a touch of honey with that vanilla creaminess in there as well. It also has like a little slight bit of a white chocolate kind of vibe. I know people have mentioned that as well, and I agree with that too. I do definitely get kind of a white chocolate vibe. It's not exactly like white chocolate though, but it has a little bit of that kind of feel to it a little bit. You do get that kind of the chocolateness to it, but more of a white chocolate, of course. It's a cross between white chocolate and like vanilla ice cream, basically. It's a really, really good scent, though. It's not exactly like any other of the vanilla scents that I've had. I don't know if it's that honey in there that makes it a little bit different, but it's a lot more creamy than some of the other vanillas, I believe, in my opinion. It's really pleasant. I really am really pleased with this candle. I've enjoyed it quite a bit. So next I will talk about the burn. So right now it is almost finished. There's probably about maybe one to two more burns at the most left on this. It's pretty far down. I burned it quite a bit of the way. And I will show you the top here to show you how the burn is right now. As you can see, it's doing pretty good now. The flames are burning fine right now. I did cotton ball it once though, early on in the candle. And after that, I didn't really have to anymore. It got a little low, but nothing where I really thought I had to cotton ball it again. And then towards the last part, actually, really, the flames got a lot higher. So that wasn't a problem at all with it. So for the most part on this candle, it's been pretty good. It did get a little bit, the wax got a little bit darker, but that kind of happens with the white candle. So that's just kind of what it is. So I don't worry too much about that. As long as I can still get a throw from it, I'm not too concerned about the darker wax color, especially in this one, because you can't see the wax color anyway, because it's got the wraparound label on there. So you can't even see it unless you look on the top anyway. So that's not really a big deal. So yeah, the burn has been not bad for the most part. I'm pretty pleased with it for the most part. At least it wasn't puning out the whole last half of the candle. And next we'll talk about the throw. So the throw, it was pretty good for vanilla scent. I would say when I had it in the bedroom, which is where I burned it most of the time, because I got more of a good scent in the bedroom, of course, because it's smaller and vanilla scents are just a little bit lighter. So in the bedroom, I would probably give it about a 6.5 to a 7 on the scent throw. Sometimes when it was really strongest point, it'd probably be about a 7. When I first burned it, it was a little bit light, and I was kind of nervous because I thought, okay, it's a little bit lighter. I could smell it was a little bit lighter, and I thought, I wish it was a little bit stronger. But then the second burn, it got a lot stronger, and I was really enjoying it. I'm like, wow, that's really nice. It was up to a 7, and we're doing really good. The first burn, probably about a 6.5. Second burn, about a 7. Then in the middle part, when it got the puny wicks, it kind of got a little bit lighter again, more on the 6.5 stage. And then after that, it kind of picked up again, and I could really smell it. And I moved it into the living room and tested it out in there. And I'd say it was doing okay in there as well, probably about a 6.5 in the living room as well. I could smell it when I lit it. So I was pretty pleased with the living room as well. It did pretty good in there as well. So yeah, the throw was, like I said, it's a vanilla scent, so they're not going to be super strong usually, but you know, 6.5 to 7. 7 for the highest, that's pretty good for vanilla scent, I believe. So I was pretty happy with this candle overall. So if you like vanilla scents that smell like ice cream, perhaps like ice cream, white chocolate kind of vibe going on there, I would get it. It's a very comforting, nice vanilla scent. It's nothing too groundbreaking, but I think it's the honey, a little bit of honey that makes it just a little bit different and made it enjoyable, not like any other scent that I've smelled really for a vanilla scent for Bath & Body Works. So thank you for watching my review of Honey Vanilla, and I will talk to you all in our next video. Bye.